Now, speaking of weddings, Bridgerton fans, this one's for you. Now's your chance to attend a real-life Bridgerton Ball in London. It's an event sponsored by the show's producers. You'll get to dress up in nice costumes. Now, choose a title for yourself and mingle with other royalty. You'll also be given a dance card. But here's the thing. It's a secret ball at a top secret location, and you have to join the waiting list to get your invite, or better known as your tickets. All we know is that it's set to take place this fall. The website is called secretbridgertonball.com. Now, I watched this series, but mainly because so many people were buzzing about it, so I had to check it out for myself. But here to help me understand more about the series and really what a ball like this means for Bridgerton fans is Marsha Eaglin, a self-proclaimed Bridgerton superfan. Hey, Marsha.
Hey, how are you?
Good. Now, thank you so much for joining us. So, okay, what does a ball like this really mean? Like, when you hear about this, what's your first instinct? Like, try to get on that waiting list?
I need to not just be on the waiting list. I need to be chosen, because the Bridgertons make you feel like you are royalty, that you're right there with them.
Yeah, now for those people who didn't quite catch the entire series or aren't too familiar with what it is, how do you best describe what Bridgerton is?
Well, my family calls me not a Bridgerton fan. They call me a Bridgerton pusher, because if you come to our house, I'm going to have you sit down and watch it. And then I'm going to watch it with you in all of the episodes multiple times. It is just, I believe, one of the most ingenuous ways of giving us a glimpse into society back in the time when a lot of us may not have paid much attention to it when we were in school. But now that we see people who look like us in these wonderful scenes, just to be able to see is just amazing.
Yeah. Now, the interesting thing, like some of the things I did catch when watching the series was I really liked how they incorporate the future with the past as well. I mean, like from the music, especially, like I think it was Ariana Grande that they were playing like full on quartet, like violins. And I was like, what? So it kind of, at first it threw me off because I'm watching these elegant big ball dresses with that kind of, and I was like, oh, but then I started liking it and I was like, I like that take. That is awesome.
Well, I think, you know, that era had, you know, the chamber music and, you know, all this very formal music, but then to be able to be young and watch this and be in a whole nother century watching what used to take place, but grooving to Ariana is like, it's just the best blend. And I think Shonda Rhimes is amazing for being able to think that through and do that for the viewers.
Yeah, definitely taking it out of the box. Very interesting take there. Now, again, this is still a very secret ball that's happening. Like, not too many details have been released. Like, we don't really know more than, you know, you're going to be getting a dance card. You can make up your own name, give yourself a name. Since you are a super fan, what kind of a name would you give yourself? Like, what family would you be a part of?
Well, I think of Lady Whistledown with this being all secretive and we're not knowing what's going on, you know? So, I don't know. I'm so used to Marsha. So I've got to think of something regal to go with that, you know? I don't know.
Yeah.
I would be Lady Marsha.
Oh, okay. I
would like
that.
To keep my name,
and
Lady
see,
Marsha.
Guys, she even added the accent. I like that. I like Lady
oh,
Marsha.
Yes. You must.
That's probably
you
my
must.
Best impression
when
there.
The Bridgertons are on in our house. This is the way we talk.
I love it. Oh my gosh, that's awesome. So obviously, again, we don't really know how much these tickets are going to cost, but we do know that it is going to be taking place in London. So would you get yourself on this list? Like, would you be willing to travel to London and go? Yep.
I'm ready. Passport is ready. I'm ready to go.
She said, sign me up. Now, what else would you like to experience at this ball? Like, what, if you, like, let's say, you know, today they said, hey, here's a ticket. What would you expect as a visitor at this ball to see or to have there?
I have to accidentally bump into the Duke, of course.
Yes.
And And then I need to put all of my theories together about Lady Whistledown.
Yes.
And make sure that I'm right, because I believe I'm right. So, you know, if nothing more than just making sure that I get to bump into the Duke.
Yes, absolutely. I think that would be at the top of everyone's list. I think it'd be very cool,
too. But I would like to see the Queen, too. I'd love to have a conversation with the Queen and be able to bow in front of Queen Charlotte.
She is very intimidating, so I give you props for that. I would be super nervous that I would say something wrong, that I, you know, she'd probably be like, I don't like your dress or something. Look at that. All right, Marsha. Well, thank you so much for tuning in and joining us for our take on this Bridgerton secret ball that we still don't have a whole lot of details to, but we are definitely looking forward to maybe some pictures that might come out down the road once it is taking place, right?
Yes, and I'll be having my Bridgerton series opener party, so we will be getting dressed.
Marsha, girl, you better invite me to that. Marsha, thank you so much. Have a great one.
Yes, thanks.
And finally, a duck. See, I'm still in Bridgerton mode. A duck from Pennsylvania is winning over the internet because of her unique look. Now, what you're seeing here is 3-year-old Gertrude. People love her hair so much. She got